Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the rematch of Unknown versus Digital Chaos. Boy, Greg, that game one was brutal.
Very brutal. It felt like DC got shut down at pretty much every turn. They had a couple, like, okay fights, but nothing even looking that convincing. Unknown basically just walked over them.
They seem to have a lot of swagger, especially versus DC. And, you know, DC, we've heard it from quite a few people who are very familiar with the players. Of course, you and I know a bit about the players as well. They aren't necessarily the most mentally strong team.
Yeah.
So that's going to be the challenge for them, is how do they not tilt here? Game two is underway, so we'll take a look at the draft while we continue discussing coming up. But DC, three straight losses of this team. The last two, very one-sided. The other game was the game where they kind of threw away their advantage and Unknown clawed themselves back in game one of their Frankfurt qualifier match.
Yeah, they've played against Unknown quite a bit.
This is going to change things up now. We'll see the reemergence of the Buryu Spiritbreaker. Probably the only hero that I've seen Buryu really have a standout individual performance on. So I am excited and curious to see if he can make something happen, because frankly, nobody else is right now.
No one else is for sure, and Unknown did steal away Buryu's Wyvern, and they even pick up the Ogre here, which is a hero that AUI has been playing quite a bit. But I do have to say, when he has been playing it, I feel like it hasn't been that good. Be honest, like, his roams have not been that effective.
He had the one game that was decent game,
but yeah. Then he had like two to three like pretty horrible ones.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
So we'll see if Unknown are able to have a bit more success with it. Given the way that this team plays, I actually expect them to have a little bit more success with it.
Do you find it interesting that Unknown opt for the Ogre over the Tusk? Again, Z-Talk has a great Tusk and it was still available. Ogre gives you a little bit more offensive potential through the Bloodlust, as well as more damage output if he gets enough farm with the Ags and the multicast, but we'll see what they have in store. Pick number four now.
Part of the reason that they picked Ogre, they did this in the other series in the Frankfurt Major Qualifier, I think they get afraid that DC are going to drag the game out like they have done the last couple times, and I think Ogre is a little bit better just because of Bloodlust in the later parts of the game.
So, good news for DC, they managed to grab Doom. You always have to be happy about that. We didn't really mention it, but now they go into the Yawar Windranger. Very individual skill-based hero. Something that doesn't naturally get out of control, but really is to make plays with Shackle Shot, nice power shots to secure kills early. He will have his work cut out for him versus Attune, but that's where having the Spirit Breaker can be very useful to try to get Yawar off to a hot start. To me, that's the big thing for DC. Yawar has struggled horribly two games in a row now. Well, with some time off between the two games. I really feel like they need to prioritize winning Yawar's lane so that he can have that explosive mid-game performance.
I completely agree. I think that should be a key for Digital Chaos. I think it should be a priority for them. And especially on a hero like Windrunner, where you can actually take that early advantage, turn it into an Ags, turn it into a damage item, and be a force on the map in team fights, be able to bring down really high HP heroes with Focus Fire. A lot of upside, I think, this game to making sure that Yawar gets pretty good farm. So we'll see if they put a bit more emphasis on it. This way, this game, they might not do it through like helping him in terms of planning hero mid. I think more likely the Spirit Breaker will charge the co-op, and then if he's next to the tree, obviously, they might be able to get a Shackle Latch on there and kill him. So Quap obviously doesn't have a ton of HP, so if you do get that Shackle Latch, you probably will die.
Yeah, definitely a game where if Quap falls behind, she's food. And Unknown. Curveball emerges as they grab Enchantress.
Offlane
Enchantress?
Question mark. Bulba did it to... I don't think it was this team, but did that to a team in Frankfurt Major, and that actually worked very well. And it was against a Huskar, but Digital Chaos don't think they're going to be banning a Huskar this game. They already have the Doom. How do you feel about Enchantress in general?
I just haven't seen enough of her to really evaluate her play.
That's kind
of
how I feel. It's like, think that there's probably some potential that even just like the untouchable, mostly stats, a couple levels in Nature's Attendance, Enchantress just like as a core could be pretty good. You can do a lot of damage with Impetus, and it is pure damage, so pretty valuable.
I guess the big change, if she's a core Enchantress, which it looks like she probably is the offlaner, is that you can now get orb effects on her, so you can get like a Mask of Madness, a Scotty, potentially.
Scotty is pretty sick.
Yeah, she benefits from all the stats. She loves the Int, because she needs the mana for Impetus. Obviously, armor is nice, HP is great, as always, and the slow helps you to chase in kite heroes. So.
Yeah, you can keep hitting them with Impetus. I really like Scotty on Enchantress.
But if she ever falls behind, my god, that hero is useless.
Yeah, she gets...
One other thing Enchantress is great for is Sneaking Roche as well, but they don't really have the best Roche lineup. No physical damage or minus armor, as of yet.
This, to me, looks like a pretty momentum-oriented draft for Unknown. I think if they don't... If they don't win the early game pretty convincingly, then they're probably just going to lose.
Like, they've given away Doom, so that always makes things a little dicey. They'll ban out Slardar now. I like the Slardar ban. That's something that can go very well with Windranger, and it gives them a reliable initiation, something Spiritbreaker does not offer you.
Mm-hmm.
Good to the same extent. And they're dire, so they won't know Rosh. Slardar's a good ban.
It also, yeah, just the minus armor with Windrunner is very good, too. There's a lot of reasons that Slardar is pretty decent in this draft, and a smart ban, I think, from Unknown. The last ban, Sven. That's interesting. I wonder...
What do they want?
Why do you pick a Sven ban? Doesn't seem like a particular...
Well, Warcry is really good against Windranger and Witch Doctor. A lot of physical damage.
Okay. Chaos Knight it is. That's not a hero I would have ever guessed.
So, maybe they're going to do safe lane Ench versus just a Doom and then run an aggressive tri-lane.
I mean, I guess the thing about this Chaos Knight is there is absolutely no clear for his illusions.
No, unless you get like a really good shackle.
Yeah.
But even then, there's still potentially three more illusions running at
you. There's basically no clear at all for these illusions. And that can make Chaos Knight really powerful even without the Wisp, because if the game goes late enough, you actually just win. Like, you ulti and you walk up the hill, and there is nothing they can do, and you just win.
I just love the fact that they're like, yeah, whatever, we'll get Chaos Knight. Let's just try something totally off the wall here and make it work.
Chaos Knight, and let's just run at them.
Oh, this is a great
brood
game.
That's a really great brood game.
That is, that is something that's going to give Unknown a lot of trouble.
Yep. Based on the draft alone, I think you have a very good chance to
win. Yeah, I agree. That said, we thought that before, and then things have troubled at times, so...
I mean, if the co-op goes crazy this game, they could easily lose.
CK's not terrible against Brood in the lane early, just because he's got a good way to catch her off the bat, but, you know, as long as Brood doesn't chain feed three times in, like, the first couple minutes, she gets to level 3 to 5, and she does bird things at that point, so... Unknown... They fifth banned the Brood last game. Perhaps they forgot about it. Perhaps they're not afraid of it. Find out soon enough if they should have been.
I think they should be, looking at their heroes.
And this is, it is an amazing Brood game.
Really good. And the game in a couple minutes, we'll get to see the Bulba Brood.
Yeah, I would favor a DC significantly. If they had been playing, it would not surprise me at all if they still stomp this game. And
yep.
Oh... Interestingly enough, here is going to be our friend, the man with many swag, playing the Enchantress. So,
Swagmaster.
Katara will be on the Chaos Knight, Atune will be on the Enchantress, Zetok, your Ogre Magi, Ryok, who was the sick Clockwork last game, will be on the Queen of Pain, and that leaves Hoshimiki as the ill-fated Wyvern, who's had a rough time staying alive. On the side of DC, you've got TC, Safe Lane Doom. Anyway, 2000, the Witch Doctor. You are on the Windranger, starting with the Sentry here off the bat. Buryu going to be playing the Space Cow, and Bulba will be in the offlane as the Brood.
I think this might be a mid-Enchantress.
I think so, too. He started with an old Tally.
He's got an old Talisman. He now has a shared Tango.
Mid-Enchantress.
Against Windrunner, pretty good. I mean, when you get some levels in Untouchable, you can't really harass her. My biggest concern is...
you can always still farm and harass with Power Shot,
yeah,
though.
That's my big...
I'm not going to question...
I mean, at this point,
I'm not going to question a Toon God. This guy is... he's a beat.
If anyone can do this, it's him. I like it. I mean, I like the unconventional pick. We'll see if it works.
And if not, they've got a game 3. So, yeah. Unknown, feeling confident here after 3 matches in a row going their way against DC. Are going to mix things up a bit, and we get underway. The Bounty Rune spawn. Windranger grabs one. Yawar, rather, and a Toon will grab the other.
For now, they've actually put the Chaos Knight in the offlane. I think they're just trying to dodge the Brood.
Uh-oh. Ryok getting the smack. Or will be harassed a bit by the Wyvern. Good start here early.
War's already getting camped by the Wyvern, but I think it was just a short term. Maybe it's not.
You can only, I mean, the Wyvern, I guess Arctic Bird has a really long cooldown, so. Yeah.
They're going to dual lane top. And it looks, I think these lanes might actually work out for Unknown.
Well, bottom lane's not.
Bottom lane.
Ryuk is
Ryuk is actually going to have. Not today.
Doom is probably going to lane here. It looks like TT just wanted to start in the jungle and eat a creep, so. It'll be a Doom Witch Doctor against a Chaos Knight Ogre. Basically, it just comes down to the Witch Doctor. If he wastes his cask and gets caught out of position, he's likely dead. It's now his turn to hot dog it up. Taro's like, Atune ain't got nothing on me. Show you what I got.
My god. What have we brought upon
these
ourselves?
These guys are swag lords. What? Are you?
Not actually hit him.
No, you just insta-canceled the charge.
Well, that's not value.
No, that is definitely 100
mana down the drain.
That one I thought he actually might pull TC and they didn't go for it.
Actually just dropping the Null Talisman mid. So glorious. It's just so glorious.
I don't even want to cast this game, Greg. I just want to laugh.
I just want to watch mid. What else happens? But so far, this Enchantress seems to be working really well. Because when he gets Power Shot, he just turns on Nature's Attendance.
Come get here. And you are trying to trade some damage here. Pops the Wind Run. Yeah. Enchantress 11-0. Already, you are losing his lane, albeit very slightly, and the lane is pushing, so you are will have his chance to catch up, but you have a breaking even on a conventional hero like this. Got pretty good about.
Bulba already has a Sol Ring. This is actually my biggest worry for him.
They're giving the Brood a lot of space. Yeah, it's definitely
Bulba is
a concern.
Getting literally everything. Like, this is not even a lane he has to worry about, really. Until the Quap is level 6, then maybe he can get bursted, but before then, he's just going to have free reign over.
You are has to be careful here.
Yeah, he's been gotten really low quite a few times. I think. Yeah, I mean, he has nothing right now, but there is a bottle coming out. Oh, damn it.
Alright, now he actually goes. They thought they were going to grab TC, and they were wrong. It's AI 2000. Flag Lord Kataro gets it done, and now TC tries to turn, but two heroes fighting it out, and while that was happy, there was also a kill. The Queen of Pain, Oshimiki, barely surviving, clawing himself away. They do have another stun on Z-Talk. Could let it go here. The charge comes through, continues to claw his way around. Stun still available, Ignite still available, but now the Witch Doctor heal comes out. And Spirit Breaker, the Space Cow, intergalactically charging all the way around the map.
He's just waiting.
He might get the bash on SR Forever as well. Nope, just onto Z-Talk. Trying to find AOI 2000. Goes in with the level 2 stun. AOI healing this up, though. Jukes through the trees. Has cockiness finally gotten the best of them. No, Splinter Blast. AOI still living. How's he got mana? I don't know. Now South healing up. That gets canceled by Hoshimiki, but SR Forever quickly losing his health. And they still haven't finished off AOI 2000. He keeps on tanking through it. He is going to survive. The double
alive.
Hero charge through from Buryu, and now the ogres respawn, and they keep on juking it out. No mercy. Now the slow into Buryu out of mana, pulled back into the Cast Knight's clutches. There is no cask. There is no way out for AOI 2000. Tick charges are available. SR Forever could possibly go for more. See now, though, with the finally the Scorched Earth up again. He's got the phase boots, and he's diving. Ogre stuns. They may turn on Z-Talk instead. SR Forever, 10 HP. Gotta be careful. He runs into auto attack range. He baits him with the stick. What a clown. Zero chance of a kill, and still doing it anyway. And, yeah, I said it earlier, but since that happened, Queen of Pain died earlier to the Broodmother. So, 4-2. Literally like a 2-minute fight. Bottom lane is a train wreck, by the way.
Yeah, bottom lane is a complete disaster for...
He's farming well, but you know this tower is going down. Ryuk has died once. Likely to die again. The pressure can begin to mount here from Bulba. Already the two Sobe Sage's Masks up. And up, there's your 17%. Charge is available. Doesn't have the lane ward, though.
And according to that Reddit Broodmother build, this is the build. Right here, double Sage's Mask. Yawar dies mid.
Z-Talk with the Roam has the Tranquil Boots up already. And do want to point out, Ryuk, a lot of this is spider lanes, you can tell from the net worth. Only 1,500, even though he's very close to the Brood CS.
I mean,
so it is going a lot worse than what that numbers tells you.
Yeah, this lane is definitely a mess for the Quap. You can't really get near the creep wave at all because
Just a couple of right clicks from Bulba can bring him down to a very dangerously low HP, especially with a Spirit Break.
And they're just going to keep on capping Yawar. Z-Talk just hanging out mid lane. They have the Hill Ward on both sides, but Yawar's Hill Ward does not actually see this particular location. Though it did see him run up the ramp, I believe. So Forever, thinking about a grab on TC. Nope, does pop to pull him in. Get Earth, now he wants to run away.
I like how he stop cancels it like four times.
Oh, they have Impetus ready. Yawar, if he gets stunned, might be in trouble here. Gets off the Shackle Shot. It's only level one. Chantress should be absolutely fine, but Z-Talk, perhaps not. Power Shot, that's a connection. Yawar will get back on track here with a kill, but it forces a two-hero rotation. Oh, not all is lost for Unknown.
DC looks like he has not been disrupted too badly during all this craziness in the top lane. He still has 20 CS and 2 kills, and he's actually holding onto the heal creep right now, but
he's almost got Doom.
Yeah.
And Hoshimiki, well, Scorched Earth on cooldown, still being charged, though SR Forever could look to turn this. The Cold Embrace is there.
Need another hero.
No points yet in Chaos Strike, so doesn't have that potential for the minus 5 armor. Yeah.
Well, they're actually maybe going to be able to kill TC here, just spending on the length stun. He gets,
no.
He gets doomed up.
They could deny. Let's see. Healed. SR Forever surviving through this. The Doom is going to keep on going, though. He'll go down. A double takedown. Digital Chaos are thoroughly back on track now.
Yep. I mean,
7-3 the score.
Mid is the only lane that's going well at all, and it is going very well for the Enchantress, but...
But she might get some kills here on the rotation. Impetus, perhaps TC even going to kill her off. Scorched Earth on cooldown, but keeps on spamming that heal creep while he engages. Enchantress out of mana. Very difficult to bring down with auto-attacks. You are even through the focus fire, not doing the most possible physical damage here. Power Shot will connect. She keeps on sprinting back as the phase boots gets charged. Gets charged, and is there going to be a bash back? As for the auto attack, no, just the body blocks doing their work. Focus fire is
the only thing that can kill.
And the bottle charge is available. Now they turn on AOI 2000. Unknown right back on the offensive, really punishing this Wind Ranger. One more slice of that scythe. Actually needs an additional one. Perhaps waits to pop the mango. You are sprinting for freedom. Oh. Gets fogged. Just the long range lob not available.
Not going to get him.
They do back off in the end, so you are. Dodging away from a bullet here, as Ryuk will get charged as well.
I think that's a pretty big deal that Yawar lives through that, both for financial and mental well-being.
Agreed. Oh, Doom's almost ready again. Didn't he just use it?
Yeah.
It's been like non-stop action.
Back up to 5-7, but overall an advantage definitely building for DC, and Bulba actually is getting very, very close for an Orchid. That's really scary. Because once he has an Orchid, you basically can't come to his lane at all unless you bring, like, 3 people.
And Enchantress even will be very vulnerable as SR Forever gets hit by some nice cast bounces, well placed. Now, the Doom out again, go for the deny. No, he's going to embrace him. Looks to keep SR Forever alive, but it's going to be close, actually, Greg. Going to be very close. He is going to live.
Living, boys.
They could have dove for that, but DC, worried about the TP rotation.
Again, another charge on the bottom lane, canceled by Buryu this time, as there is now an Ogre here.
Oh, you're not fighting those spider lanes. But, well, maybe if Quap drops the ultimate, could clean up most of the spider lanes, but a fresh spawn deployed, has the Scream available. At least gets some gold for that, but Bulba marches after the Quap. Blake in 1 second! Just barely. TP? No mana.
He's no mana.
Bulba's gonna get him, and the dust is blown here. Z-Talk. No, the stun? Maybe? No, but Enchantress has arrived. Nice rotation coming in from Attune, making it 7-8. Honestly, that is totally worth it.
Yeah, definitely worth it. You are mid lane getting hit by the tower. You got pulled back very far. And it looks like the Enchantress is just going to be going for HP because she knows that really Focus Fire and Magic Nukes are the only way for her to die. So just getting a little bit of extra HP goes a long way because with Max Untouchable, you basically can't attack her. Like, it actually takes forever.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
I kind of like this. I like the Enchantress here. Seems to be working really well. You definitely can't pick this every game, but I think it has its uses.
I'm just curious if he can keep up in farm. Like, at this point, he's doing well. 3-0-0.
I was wondering if he was going to get a Midas. It seems like
it used to be pretty popular for carry Enchantresses, even like supports that want to play, that want to transition into more of a semi-carry role, but I'm not sure if he can fit it in, because Bulba's getting aggressive. He's infesting the jungle. And they are about to be under a lot of pressure from DC.
They have a pest problem in the bottom lane, and it's not really going to be going away.
Oh, they know Bulba's in the neighborhood. Spiderling's come out. Z-Talk has the dust form.
This is kind of the biggest takeaway from that guide about the guy who teaches pro players Brood is just abuse the living hell out of the fact that you can hide in the trees, and if they don't have a way to kill the trees, then they just can't see you.
And the other thing is just applying pressure and coming to fight. So we've seen some broods just entirely on rat. They never leave their lane, but this is the kind of patented way to play now that Mag was really perfecting at ESL.
Charge again. Another scream is going to kill most of these spiderlings, but Ryu's just...
Ryu's diving for this. Ogre's coming in, though. The power shot. Oh, he cleans up the whole wave of spiderlings. Big gold. Now Buryu trying to retreat. They do have the stun. They hold it until the last possible second, and now Buryu going to go down. Tries to charge out. Won't happen. Yawar cutting the wave, and Bulba looking to recreate his spiderling army. Yawar in very deep. Does get the shackle shot off onto Ryo.
Heal him.
Heal to keep him alive a bit longer. Not enough. Yawar does get the kill, but he pulls another guy. Bulba! With the overextension, and the chain feed commences. Three heroes down. Two of those. Very unnecessary. But
oh boy.
While that was going on, Chaos Knight, I think he got doomed and just dove. Days. Yeah. Chaos Knight's feeling quite useless. 2,000 net worth. His ogre's at 3,500. But he will complete his treads now. And hey, I guess if nothing else, you always have Chaos Strike, right?
Yeah. I'm mostly worried for DC just because this Enchantress is huge. 5-0 with 60 CS.
What is the next item? There's the
bags. I mean, you could go straight Ags, you could go pack speed early, you could get like an AC for armor for your team.
But... Bushimiki! No! Oh, God. Yeah, suck on that!
It's a really sad, sad place to be.
It is a very sad place to be.
Just sit there.
The double rune grab for a Toon God. Now they have a gem up on the ogre, so they want to hunt the brood, it seems. They're going to smoke. Invis available if the Enchantress wants to be in front, and she will. She'll be the scout. Middle tower is under attack. And they head towards top. Unfortunately, nobody's home.
Yeah, nobody's there. Yawar is mid, though. I would like to see them wrap. But I don't think they have higher aspirations, probably looking for the doom. But TC's at base right now. He has finished up with Vlad's.
TC, perhaps anticipating this, are now bringing two heroes into mid. More to come any moment, and they make their move. On to Yawar. Blink. Scream is there. Queen of Pain ultimate available. Not yet. Sonic waving. They're trying to body block Yawar. Going for the double kill takedown. They have no Winter's Curse yet. Yawar, get the shackle off. Beautifully placed on two heroes. The Death Ward comes through along with the Doom, and that's how you get rid of the Enchantress. Just nuking the ever-living crap out of her. Quaffle is ready. The Spiderlings could be fed here momentarily, but no mana for the ultimate. Ryok being forced back, level death onto Z-Talk. T also retreats. They are charging, but they'll settle for the 1-for-1. An Enchantress for a Windranger, but considering how fat the Enchantress was, like a bit of a win for DC, though they had to commit the bigger ults for it.
Looks like it's actually going to be a Yules.
On the quad?
For the Enchantress.
Oh, double Yules. So, way to deal with the Doom. Sorry, not the Doom. The Orchid, of course. Not too shabby.
TC has 6 kills. Jesus. A lot of kills for a Doom. And I guess every time he's doomed, Sony's gotten the kill, and there's been so much action up there.
They are making their go. TC, very tanky, though. Has the free Hurl Boulder. Thinking about a jump, the Shackle latches on Ryok, but he's inside the trees, not visible. They get the web out. Already, Spiderling's being punished and cleaned up. Gem available, and that will allow them to farm these. Bulba is feeding a lot of spider gold.
Yeah. I was thinking about the last team fight, and I guess he just did an ulti because he knew it wouldn't kill Yawar, so he'd rather just keep screaming, get more damage for his mana.
Yeah, and save the ult for a better fight. It's also only a level 1 ultimate, so... Yeah,
probably just save it for, like... He's almost level 11. Probably wants to get level 2.
They're gonna smoke again, Greg. They have the gem. DC in a great position, but there is a Winter's Curse available. They're gonna slow him down. Curse him! He didn't have the Scorched Earth. This is the death of the Doom. 321.
Oh, the Doomlings.
Yum, 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 yum.
They're dead.
It's always fun.
Yeah.
Short-lived.
So Brood is now going back for the phase boots, which makes sense. You definitely need to get phase boots on this hero, I think. Just being able to get path through your own spiderlings when you're out of the web makes it worth it.
Yeah, I've seen so many... Back when the Treads build was more popular before ESO, we saw so many Broods just get, like, blocked by the spiderlings.
Yeah, you just get stuck.
You take damage, you're just trapped in your webs, and...
Awful.
I mean, sometimes you can't go anywhere anyway, but... Yeah, you don't have the phase boots, the chances go up quite a bit.
Mm-hmm. Ryu is just continuing to push out bottom with the help of Hoshiki. Hoshimiki, so close. Combine some names there. But I honestly... I mean, what's the timing for Unknown? Like, what do you do with this Enchantress? That's the only thing I'm curious about. You just keep trying to apply pressure. It's towers. I mean, they haven't killed a single tower. They haven't gotten Roshan. What are they actually doing with their farm? And what is the Chaos Knight buying? Because he is almost 2k gold.
I think he's getting a Midas, possibly.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking.
Like, if you don't get a Midas here, you're just not catching up this game.
Yeah. Agreed.
I think you risk it. Go for the Midas. A super farm Chaos Knight this game is...
Incredibly.
Almost unstoppable.
Yeah, basically unbeatable.
Unless they're just dooming him every fight before he's able to get off his ultimate. But yeah. They have, as you mentioned right away in the draft, they have no control. And especially no damage to clear illusions. It's all single target.
I mean, they could, like, get an Ags on the Witch Doctor and use the entire ulti, but that would, like, probably barely clear them. You know, that's the kind of point that...
Mm-hmm.
They're at with this Chaos Knight if he gets big, so I think DC should probably try to use this Brood just to create as much lane momentum as possible and just continue being aggressive, because if this game does go late enough, and we've seen DC delay games extremely late for basically no reason, it's very, very possible that Unknown will just...
What was the stat by Motpex? It was two. They're 2-7 in 50-minute plus games.
And if that lasts...
And then I think the one of the games in that series they actually lost as well, so maybe it's 2-8.
2-8 now.
Not 100% sure, but
DC hopefully
not the best
a little earlier. Splinter Blast is very good against Brood, though. That's one thing they have going for them as terms of push.
Shackle on the Z-Talk. He's the gem carrier. They're gonna put him under, but that curse onto TC. That's gonna help.
God.
Vulva just shredding his ally, and now the Queen of Pain initiates, but didn't get off her Yule Scepter. I think she got bashed.
Yeah, I think she.
That hurts.
She died really
but they saved the gem. Honestly, trading your Queen of Pain but saving your gem, I think that's worth it, especially against the Brood.
Now they're gonna
Tune going though. Down here may not be worth it. Enchantress retreating out, but they're gonna have vision for the charge.
Can't really kill him, they'd have to death ward him.
Ogre's coming, but so too is the Brood. They're gonna Bloodlust one, multicast the other, turn the Imps and start going to work, and Buryu drops fast to this.
Crazy.
Well, DC, collecting another
DC
kill.
DC are just continuing the pressure. I think they know that this game is... definitely on a timer. It's a long timer.
What is Chaos Knight? I guess he's just rushing Armwind at this point. 2800 gold. He's just been static farming this top lane for ages.
Yeah.
What does he want?
Oh. Sure, I mean, if it's not Midas...
Oh, it's definitely not Midas.
Yeah, it's definitely not Midas. Yeah, I mean, what's the next choice? I mean, I guess he could buy, like, a big item, like a...
Yarn straight heart.
Like a Reaver. Yeah, I don't know.
Armor's just such a value item.
Reaver's actually not horrible. I mean, if he just tanks up.
You are being slowed down. Now they blink in, initiating. Doom comes out onto Ryok. Winter's Curse, not available for 20 seconds. They get the Death Ward going from the tree line. That forces back the Enchantress, and they will take down the Quap. DC, a good start to the fight. Gonna back off. They still hold the Aegis here. Lone Outer Tower remaining. Is that tier 2? See?
Yeah.
Showing some good resilience here in the mid game. Now up 7,500 gold, 500 experience, so very close there.
Honestly,
and like you said, Greg, they are the ones applying pressure.
Yeah, and they should just continue to do so. And I think the bigger benefit, you know, obviously it's great that this Chaos Knight is getting farmed, but he's also getting a ton of solo XP, so he's going to have level 2 Phantasm very soon.
Radiance Rush? I mean,
I have no idea what he's buying. I'm not even going to speculate.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I'm looking through items here and.
At this point, he's got anything he wants except a relic.
Yeah. Dire's middle tower is under attack. I'm curious.
But yeah, he's been static farming. Like, the lane has not pushed from here in forever, so... I think this is something DC should be a bit concerned about. Yeah, the CK's farm is mediocre now, but he gets... first big item, if left unchecked, and they are gonna charge him now. So it seems they are finally deciding that they want to deal with this fella.
I'm gonna need some help. He is pretty tanky.
Oh, this is like the perfect time to kill him.
Yeah, if he dies right now, like, I don't know.
Is he really going relic?
What is happening right now? What is he buying? I'm so confused. I guess one way to farm on Chaos Knight is to buy a Radiance, right?
Works for Alchemist. Works should work for me too. Oh, there's 3,800 gold and counting. Do you want? Yumiki gives him the lane ward. You're about to walk right by it, so looks like this gank attempt will be thwarted.
I know this is coming. It's actually making me anxious that he has not spent this gold.
Spend your gold!
If it is a Radiance, he can't get the relic now.
If he goes home and buys like an armlet or something, I'm gonna be so annoyed. Radiance top
tower is under attack. All the speculation for nothing.
Really? Okay. Well, BKB it is.
Not even like do. It stops you from getting shackled, but like, what if you just get doomed? I don't get why.
I guess that means they're not dooming the Enchanter, so the Quaff who are probably the real damage dealers.
All right.
Well, it's just very odd to not buy the components. Like, if he dies there, he loses so much unreliable gold. And it's pretty much all unreliable because he's just been getting creep kills.
Well, they're gonna go on TC here. They Yule's him up. He is almost certainly gonna go down here.
Now TC caught out, pulled into the pain train, and he heals, but not enough. Now the Chaos Knight illusions are coming, and they move on to AUI, pulling him back. BKB deployed off with your head too, Bubba. But now SR Forever left a bit on his own. He's going to pull Buryu back in and doing so. Also get himself to safety. The two-hero shackle by Yular hangs on to the fight, but Bulba will be focused down, and in the end, a 4-for-2 exchange.
Oh, they're going to get...
Catching out Yular. Imps crashing in. No more wind run available. Power shot. Not going to be enough for a kill there. Missed the Queen of Pain. It was fleeing. And they get the 4-for-2 exchange. So, a big win for Unknown. They're just super decisive. When they want to fight...
When they fight, they're like, five-man smoke, hit their tower, kill them all. And then they go back to the business.
It's not none of this like half-ass, like, let's kind of smoke and dilly-dally around, and let's maybe back off because we're a little nervous, or we haltingly go
just
and
run right into them.
Just sprint directly towards the nearest enemy here like a heat-seeking missile and go ham.
Fuels combo him down. He does not get a great Doom off. Even have Doom in that fight.
Well, BKB out for your brood now, Bulba. He is... He's at that point in the game where broods do tend to struggle a bit, though.
Yeah, this is the awkward part of the game. It's like, well, can't really one-shot, or I can't just like run at the supports anymore, because I kind of mostly have an item that lets them get away from me.
Wyvern has a...
Wyvern has a four-staff now, and Ogre has a Glimmer Cape, so... What do you really do? And I think the answer is you just completely take over the jungle. Or, you know, Bulldog, like, farms the Ancients when he gets in this position. I wonder what kind of build he's going to go for from here. I mean, obviously he could go with something like Necrobook if they want to apply pressure, but Scotty is really good on Brood.
Feeling a little late to go for something
like Necrobook. Yeah, I think Necrobook is... The time has probably passed for that.
It's just not a very popular in Brood in general now. Yeah. We see much more of that... You get BKB, it's
more of like a fighting Brood now. So I think he's I think it's more like he'll go for, like... like an SNY or an MKB even, or like a Scotty. I think Scotty is the best item on Brood when you're in kind of the position, but I could see getting another item in between.
As for Enchantress, tune up to 3,300 gold.
You probably just get HP and attack speed, and I don't know.
Aghanim's is great.
Aghanim's is really good.
Of course.
Aghanim's
I think Ags Scotty or Ags... If you want to be risky, you can get Mask of Madness, but against the Doom Wind Ranger, that's
I think you get all the items, other items first, then if you still decide you want to get Mask of Madness, you can get it at the end. But
agreed.
I think it's probably
Eggs now, but we'll see.
I'm on board of that train.
Queen of Pain, also up to 2,000, so as the game slows down, DC is also backing off to farming. Yuar does have his own eggs. Doing decently well here, all things considered. Certainly better than some of the games he's had as of late. But now Unknown look to change that. They smoke.
Rain over. Little conga line. Bulba's hiding in... Now I'm deeming the Bulldog spot. Right here. Where Bulldog always hides out when he plays Brood. And just goes... Kills the Ancients, gives you vision of
the
roast.
This is gonna give me nightmares. Can you imagine this thing just, like, hanging on the ceiling above your bed?
Yes, I can, actually. And Does not make me feel good.
It's not a good feeling.
I would certainly hope not. If that's a good feeling, then you got issues.
Vit booster for the Chaos Knight, so I guess he's probably just going to go Heart next. I guess you just get levels and try to use the Phantasm. I don't think... He doesn't really have enough opportunity to get farm to get Manta, I don't think.
They're going to press in bottom now. SR Forever and Z-Talk. Up in front, the bullies. Moment, DC. Opt for a smoke of their own. They're going to swing around through the Roshan pit. Boba moving up the cliff. Radiant squad does have some okay vision here from the ward and good positioning by Hoshimiki. Very unlikely to be the first man caught out. Smoke close to breaking. They're looking for the UR. Two hero shackle. He blinks in. He nails it. Beautifully placed. And now SR Forever in trouble, but they curse TC as the death ward comes through. Z-Talk going to die to the death ward. SR Forever likely to be next. He'll go down. Excellent jump by UR, and it leads to 2-3 kills in the end.
Yep.
Bringing everybody down.
I mean, that was just the perfect initiation by UR, so that fight goes pretty much the exact way they expected. The good news for Unknown is that the only ulti that got expended over that fight was Cursed because it was so short.
And frankly, they lost what I would consider 3 supports. Chaos Knight, just kind of his farm is okay, but the item build he's gone for, he's not a big damage dealer right now. Unless Phantasm is up and he's able to constantly get off the reality rifts. So keeping alive your Enchantress allows Attune to complete his Aghanim Scepter. Quap to 3,300. Perhaps goes for an Ags of her own. Some delicious Spiderling farm. But now the Aegis going the way of DC.
I think Ags still seems pretty good this game if you're Quap. Even though it's a little bit later than we normally see in Ags, I think it's probably still fine.
Other main possibility at this point, your Hex. Good lockdown for Windranger, but now you are, finally, second life. Been a while since we've seen him with an Aegis.
It has been a while. It seems like DC have not really been in position over like the last couple of games to ever really get take a good Roche fight, but they do get it off the back of that last one. Duar is playing much better this game, clearly much more in his comfort zone, has gotten a little bit more room, he didn't really get camped as badly, and he is playing much better as a result.
Yeah, to me, essential for DC, that they have at least an acceptable star in Duar. It doesn't have to be a dominant one.
You don't have to like go crazy, but he can't get camped like that, I don't think. I don't think they can win when that happens.
And a lot of that's credit to the Broodmother. This is just not a hero, even the Doom. Just two heroes that will win their lanes if they're not under a ton of pressure early, and even when they are, they off to do anyway, so kind of shifted focus away from the Windranger, and that's where UR has an easier time of it.
Chaos Knight is just still farming.
Oh, by the way, I don't think we mentioned it, but I believe they lost the Ogre Gem in that last fight. It's now in Buryu, so pretty big loss. Now charging onto SR Forever. He pops the BKB, but Doom still comes out, and UR chunks him down. BKB. I mean, as we talked about, just useless if the Doom's used.
I don't really get why BKB was purchased this game.
The way he built it was weird, and
I feel like he honestly should have just bought the heart. I feel like that would have been better than BKB.
It's definitely better versus Doom.
I mean,
the only stuff you can really block is the cask and the shackle shot.
The thing is if UR plays it right, you're probably not going to get the BKB off or shackle anyway. Unless it's like a really long range shackle.
No glyph used here by the Radiant. UR though taking a massive amount of damage. He may lose his Aegis. Tuck wants to punish. They know also that the Doom is on cooldown. Buryu diving deep, getting drugged back. And TC will use this opportunity to get the silence off on Hoshi. Managed to get off of Winter's Curse just yet, though he may turn and use it on Buryu. The Death Ward comes from AO 2000, a zoning Death Ward ball. Focus fire
doing?
From YC allows them to. Or rather, you are allows them to mostly take down the first lane of action. Now, your Chaos Knight desperately trying to get a pullback from the Reality Rift, but doesn't have the vision necessary. Now the Yules onto TC's Doom, catching him out. Deploying the ultimate from the Chaos Knight. Looks like TC will be punished here, but the exchange might be UR getting another kill. Winter's Curse onto UR, but he still has the great ultimate. Ryok chucking out damage, and now they'll finish off Bulba on the Broodmother. Chasing forward, UR blinking away. He's the Aegis carrier, but low. See, how much time left on the Aegis? A couple minutes here, so he should have the second life no matter what in this chase, and now Enchantress cutting him off. Where are you going? Hey, over here. But she's already gone.
Yeah, I think he wanted to wait to use the Yules, obviously, so UR played that one really well. Makes it out just barely.
So they lose the Brood, they lose the Doom, they take a tier 3. They do not get the melee. And it's now healing. Did we just not get a fight recap for that? Or did I miss it?
I think you missed it. Train wreck Thursday.
RIP.
DC have taken pretty commanding advantage in this game. That last fight did not go great for them, and we saw part of the reason why I was kind of worried about the Chaos Knight. I mean, as soon as he does get the Phantasm off, Brood dies. You know, they use this on another hero, he dies, but Brood can't really do much at all against those Chaos Knights, and if his BKB runs out, he's just gonna get stunned and killed immediately, and that's very, very bad for Digital Chaos. I mean, any hero really is just food for the Chaos Knight in this game.
And speaking of DC, they're about to get their Deso AC. Deso just not completed on Ywar, so doing an okay job of keeping his farm up right there with the Enchantress, just behind his other two cores, and at the same moment, we're going to see Bulba building into the Assault Caress. So the physical damage and the pushing potential of this DC lineup is about to level up in a big, big way.
Like you mentioned, it looks like it's going to be a Hex for Ryu, and given how that last fight went, I think I actually like that. They need an instant disable for the Doom.
The Doom, even the Wind Ranger, yeah, and you can cancel the Death Ward. There's a lot of ways where the Hex can come in handy.
I think they just need to make sure that the Chaos Knight doesn't get owned like that.
But this item is even more important. Hoshimiki, he's done a great job of keeping his farm up, considering how much map control they've lost. Blink and Force online on the Wyvern with the level 2 ult.
So now they should be pretty much get Good Winter's Curse every single fight, because there's no reason for the Winter Wyvern to be close to them at all. I mean, he has great mobility items now and can set up the fights accordingly. Hopefully, at least. That's the goal.
Scythe under construction. I'll nearly complete now, so I'll have that one soon. What's a Toon go for? 2600 gold. MKB is also another possibility, I think, just to deal with Windrun.
Bulba's going for AC, so I think that mostly is going to be boosting the Wind Ranger. It doesn't. The defensive armor is...
Alright, he's going MKB. Okay. MKB with Bloodlust, level 4, against the Wind Ranger, she is going to get shredded by the Enchantress.
MKB is definitely the item.
Slightly risky build, but you do have the Yules defensively, and basically you're just counting on... If they go on you, that means Chaos Knight gets to move around freely in the fights, and they hopefully get the Good Winter's Curse, so... I think it's an acceptable risk here.
Yeah, I'm on board with it. There's not that much that can kill her, so...
God, look at that damage.
I know, yeah, this is... It's actually crazy. Now that she's level 16 and has the Aghanims, she deals damage incredibly fast. Heroes get, like, 4-shot.
If only you could use Impetus on towers.
That would be... And that's the dream. Bloodlust. I'll boost the damage.
This is a scary Enchantress.
They're definitely going to want to try to use Doom on her, just to make sure that they can win the fight easily.
Especially if they get caught off guard by the MKB and lose a fight, then you know Enchantress will be the focal point next time around.
Because if she does get Doomed, I mean, she's basically just...
Charge goes on to mid, and they isolate SR forever, and...
Doesn't
he's
buy
dead
that.
Forever. Now TC being hammered by Bulba during this time, though the Doom may go down with Galick getting off his ultimate. He does! Big kill, but Quap... Perhaps the trades, Chaos Knight into the fray, has not popped his BKB, gets bashed, chain stunned for days. That's a dieback on the Chaos Knight shackle, not gonna connect.
Don't get why you wouldn't use your BKB if you're going in that scenario.
I think he was holding it, but just, yeah, punished.
The Phantasm, so long to cast, you should just use it beforehand.
That shackle, though, Enchantress kept alive for now, charge, bashing her back, AUI 2000. Gonna be left to his own devices against the very fast and angry Enchantress. Now hexing Ywar, big reveal, and they do finish off AUI. Ywar looking to run, but he is slowed down. They want to bring the Enchantress back in here. Has the Impetus ready. Buryu in position, though. 3-3. The total deaths, including the Chaos Knight dieback, a 4-3. And now, they're not done yet. Buryu with the deep charge. Onto Enchant again, more than anything, trying to protect Ywar, who found a shackle after that initiation, and will get yet another kill. The chase continues in earnest. Buryu retreating out, Ignite slowing him down, but has a charge in 1 second, so he should make it out. In fact, no! Ding, ding, ding! He runs back in and feeds! I think he was expecting Ywar to get in there, but Ywar went for the backstep, gets the solo kill. He wants detog as well, no teleport scroll. He's gonna man up on this, but there's a wind run. No, he TP's out, he's playing it safe. Honestly, I think he probably could have killed Zetok there, but heroes were respawning, so... Not worth the risk. I like the discipline from Ywar.
Buryu just feeding over the gem, and...
That was very strange.
Certainly questionable.
He was expecting Yawar to come back in and help him, but Yawar was busy hunting the Enchantress, and ultimately Enchantress, the maybe not the better kill with the gem, but at least an equally valid kill, I would say. But MKB is almost done, Greg, and that means trouble
this
for Enchantress.
This is going to be nasty with MKB. Yawar has been relying on the wind run so heavily to live through these fights. He's just going to get immediately killed.
And let's remember how that fight started. Esper Forever gets caught out, he dies. He then buys back, does not BKB, instantly dies again. These fights are way different if he's getting off his ultimate in BKB. So a lot of it for Unknown just comes down to better positioning and patience and calmly ensuring that they have the extra beef in the front lines.
Mm-hmm. Shimiki is going to be crucial as well. And that last fight was kind of a weird curse just because there was none of his heroes around. But with Brew just slamming him right next to him, they were still able to kill TC before the Doom goes off. And that
I
was
feel like
really
Brew, Bulba's done more damage to his team than to the enemy team in these fights because he's either unable to auto-attack or he's cursed hitting an ally. But he's rarely hitting enemy heroes. The weakness of the bird, even if you go for the more combat-oriented build.
Man, Z-Talk's just taking all the map control back. He's already gotten a couple wards, I think.
Perhaps more importantly, protecting his freshly planted wards by removing the gem. Don't know if we mentioned some of these ags, but there's now an ags out on the Doom, as well as the AUI 2000 Witch Doctor.
Yeah, and ags on the Doom is pretty mandatory because you need to be able to disable Untouchable.
That's true. Or you can get a mass BKBs, I guess, but...
Yeah, that's true as well.
It's definitely a nice plus.
Yawar is going to be the one to pick up the Aegis, and he has been performing extremely well this game. Has the Desolator, so it's his damage item completed, and in the last fight we saw how much damage that actually did. And now, as a result, the Radiant are just going to be pushing top lane, trying to put a little bit of pressure on the tower here. But they're all retreating. I think they know that they're going to need some TPs if they don't have them already to defend the assault that's about to go on bottom and mid.
Does DC have the confidence to walk up to high ground here and really take the fight enemy's way?
This has been their weakness in the past, is not being able to execute these fights.
They are sieging. Nice setup here. They did not glyph before the tower goes down, but Buryu dives in extremely deep, way behind enemy lines. Meanwhile, Yawar taking heavy damage, but they match the Doom. The Enchantress, the two hero shackle. Although they curse TC, nobody's actually forced to attack him during this time. And Enchantress does not have buyback pulling in Buryu. BKB about to wear off the Death Ward, zoning everyone back. Yawar survives. Buryu lives. They all do. Now rushing in again, aside from Bulba, the one man down. A staggered retreat by DC. They will pull back Yawar, trying to get rid of the Aegis. He's a bit too tanky. A long glass will finish him off. Queen of Pain ult already extended. Buryu galloping forward. He takes one for the team. Not sure if it was necessary. Now Yawar fishing for a shackle. Eyes on the prize for the melee Rex here with no Ench for 40, no Winter's Curse, no Phantasm, or Queen of Pain ult. This will be a very tough hold.
Tried it anyway. Ryu's moving forward here. AUI healing up in the back. He's Invis, still healing from Cold Embrace, but not able to get a lot of damage done here. And Yawar is just dealing so much damage throughout the course of this fight. He's still near full HP. There's not enough mana for Fire Blast on the Ogre. So Yawar continuing to waltz around here now. Maybe needs to be a little bit more careful. He does have Windrun in just a couple of seconds. Splinter Blast is going to come out. Yawar turns around. Focus fires down on Z-Top, but Cold Embrace is going to save him at the last moment. Power Shot not enough to get through that Cold Embrace, but Yawar still on the assault. Now he's really low. TC's back. Ryu is going to use himself
up. Yawar
heals up.
They passed him the cheese,
yeah,
it looks like.
He was handed the cheese. He full heals, and now they're back. And I think they're just going to continue the assault and get the last for Axe.
They have a buyback on Quap, and Enchantress has returned to do battle.
Yeah, Yawar just going to walk up here, try to bring this down, and he kills it so fast. It's going to get chunked by the Enchantress. You can start to see the amount of damage that she can do, but a really good engagement there by DC. And now push forward the Enchantress. They do have Doom, but no, there's not enough mana for Doom, so they can't actually Doom her. BKB is used by TC, and look at how slow he attacks, but does not matter. Eventually goes down, and that might be the end of it for Unknown, as they do not have buyback on the Enchantress or the Wyvern. And Enchantress is really all of their damage. The Quap does a little bit, but no Aghanims means reduced damage, and they're just not able to live through that fight when the Enchantress gets doomed at the beginning.
DC, have they finally gotten the monkey off their back and taken a clean win here over Unknown? It just may be the Brood Doom duo.
I think if you're going to pick Enchantress like this, you need to ban Doom. It's one of the only heroes that can shut her down that hard in team fights.
Ah, Bulba!
I would have gotten harder if he had gotten it destroyed.
Little touche there coming out from the brood.
I can actually completely imagine what Bulba said, and I said, you know, fuck these guys. I'm just going to drop my item. Let him know.
Then he dies.
Exactly like that. Just fuck these guys.
I'm sure there's a little frustration after the way that last game went, and they're letting it out now on Unknown, getting yet another kill. The GG is called Unknown, forced into a deciding game number 3.
Pretty cleanly executed by DC. I feel like that game mostly went according to plan. Near the end, the co-op was building a Lincolns. I wonder if the right choice was to build Lincolns earlier and stack them onto the Enchantress just...
so she can actually do damage instead of just getting doomed and dying.
Yeah. TC was just not going to doom anyone but the Enchantress. I kind of have the hiccups here.
Great individual shackles by Yuar that game.
Or good. He dropped all his items too. It's spreading. Coming contagious.
And a Dota. Learning from the South Americans. It's truly a cooperative globalization process that we're experiencing here, Greg. As everyone around the world unites and shares discoveries about Dota with each other, it feels so wholesome and positive. The warm energy just billows out.
I feel like every time that someone drops their items like that, a stat person cries. It's like,
Brian cries.
Yeah.
K-pop was crying a lot during the qualifiers for Frankfurt.
But that's life. Furry dropped his items, and pretty easy game number 2, it feels like, for DC. So
giving away the Doom first pick, that felt okay to me, but the 5th pick Brood, that's to me where they got caught off guard. We said it early, as soon as the draft ended, we thought DC had the better draft and should win if they played decently. I think they played decently.
Yuar
played really well. Some kind of costly overextensions by a few of the other players, but nobody had a terrible game, and it's enough for DC game 2.
Yeah, the Enchantress being the sole real source of damage definitely hurts them, and